Hey guys, so this is my third video on me talking about my path to U.S. citizenship. I'm not currently a U.S. citizen yet, but I'm a permanent resident, and that was through my mom really struggling hard with the English proficiency exam. You know, if it wasn't for her incredible effort, I would not be here today as a permanent resident. Really, I have my mom to thank for that. And my dad would have to thank my mom for that as well. So, I don't know, my family, my dad, and we have just a lot of things we need to thank my mom for. She's done a lot for this family, that's for sure. But even with permanent residency, for me, it wouldn't take, would take quite a while, until recently, to actually start applying for U.S. citizenship. So, one big reason is, well, actually, before I get to that, so my mom became the first person in my family to become a U.S. citizen. You know, we moved to Tennessee eventually, and then after she moved, she was like, oh, I should apply for U.S. citizenship. I actually don't know what was her drive behind that, other than maybe she just, I guess by that point, my family kind of have this kind of agreed that there is this unsaid but implicit general consensus, we're not ever going to be living in Korea again, right? I think there's that feeling. So my mom is more proud at this point, more attached to United States, I think, than to Korea. She has a lot of resentment towards Korea, and maybe, I don't think I want to disclose that so much, but yeah, just that she has a lot of resentment toward Korea. So she became a U.S. citizen first. It was kind of difficult for her, you know, because of the language issue mostly, and also because she applied to be a citizen when after we moved to Tennessee. So because we were living in California, we lived in California for over 10 years, and then after that, she moved to Tennessee, and she lived in Tennessee for about 6 months. And then she applied to become a U.S. citizen. So U.S. citizenship counts your past residence. So it has to be where you have to apply for U.S. citizenship where you last lived for 3 years or something like that. So she had to apply in California. So whenever she had to do something U.S. citizenship related, she had to fly to California. So that was one part of the struggle. But the other part of the struggle was, of course, the language thing. Because part of the U.S. citizenship requires you to do this oral interview exam, which tests English proficiency and knowledge of the U.S. government and politics and whatnot. Basic knowledge, very basic. My mom studied hard for that. I worked with her too. I would quiz her. I would teach her. So she got ready. She really, really practiced hard to get ready. And so she passed, and she became a U.S. citizen first. I was planning on it too. I have my reasons, you know, that I mentioned. But I couldn't become one until very recently. The reason is money. See, before becoming a U.S. citizen didn't cost as much. Now, do you know how much it costs now? The application fee is $587. That's the application fee. That's not including the fingerprint fee. Fingerprint fee is like $150 or something like that. All I know is that the entire fee for becoming a U.S. citizen is over like $680. Okay? I didn't have $680 to spend to become a U.S. citizen. Until I started getting that money when I started working at a homeless shelter. So I started having money. But then life circumstances happen, I have to make my loan payments and credit card payments and blah, 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 and all that. So even with two jobs, I still couldn't get enough extra money for U.S. citizenship saving. And then I got fired from my shelter, and I have all this extra money from all the comp hours I accrued turning into money and unemployment benefits. I had a lot of money. But I wasn't going to spend any of that money towards U.S. citizenship because I was unemployed. I needed to save that money because I was unemployed. and I need to be looking for a job. So, for a long time, I couldn't apply for U.S. citizenship because of money. And then, funny thing happened 2 years ago. My aunt, living in Korea, she actually sent my mom money, like $900, to give to me so that I could become a U.S. citizen, which was very generous of my aunt. I was like, oh my gosh, that's amazing. So I was going to use that money to become a U.S. citizen, but life circumstance happened, which is my cousin came to Maryland to interview for a grad school there, to become enrolled in, to think about, you know, enrolling into a grad school program there. She eventually didn't end up going there. She went to Washington State or University, I think. So I don't know specifically where she went to, but she's in Seattle now. Anyway, but yeah, she went to interview. I went to Maryland to meet her. She had rented a car, and I drove it, and I kind of had an accident. So the $900, unfortunately, went to, because of the accident. I had to spend that money because of the accident. And I explained to my cousin, like, I'm not supposed to be using my money. This money was promised to me for something else. You know, I can't really do this, but, you know, was really pressured. She's like, my family's struggling too. Like, we have to do this, like, you know, and I caused the accident. So I was like, okay, I guess this is going to this. So for a long time, I was like, how the hell am I going to be, you know, I felt guilty because I was supposed to be using that money. I was given that money to become a U.S. citizen, but I didn't. So now I felt like a liar and a thief in a way to my aunt, which is horrible. But so that I don't end up breaking that promise, I did eventually get money very recently. I think I applied with that money in November or December, I think. I think that's when I finally had the money after starting grad school for social work. That's when I was like, okay, the thing that's been holding me back to be able to apply all this time was $680. It's the one thing that's been holding back. You know, and I think that's a big hurdle, I think. Just to become a U.S. citizen, you need that much money. Now, for many people, $680 is, for some people, you know, maybe it's not that big of a deal. You know, it doesn't sound that big, but I don't know. To me, it was that amount of money was always a big struggle to come up with to spend, for me. But then again, I've always had jobs that had lousy pay. You know, working at this homeless shelter. That job, my salary was like $32,000, you know, barely that. So, yeah, you know, my pay's always been low because I've only had a bachelor's. After I get my master's and get more kind of connected with the field learning opportunity certificates and things like that, I'm sure my pay will be better than I've ever had before. Although the social work field is not known for high pay. I'm expecting that. That's fine. But yeah, that's why becoming a U.S. citizen took so long, because it cost that much. I think many people don't realize that applying to be a U.S. citizen costs $680. It really does nowadays. It used to cost like in the 80s it used to cost like $300. In the 70s. $200. In the 60s, I think I've heard that it was like $40, you know, but that's not including inflation, so $40 at a time is still a lot of money to apply to be a U.S. citizen, but money was definitely a huge issue for me.